this life has anything to gain at all.
My name is John. My wife Sandra and I have been married for 26 years, and we've lived and served in the Puget Sound area for the last 19 of those. We have two daughters, Rebecca, who is a registered nurse and lives in Tacoma with her husband Pat, and Megan, who is a freelance photographer, supervisor at Starbucks, and lives in Puyallup with her husband Greg.
Every glance, every dance, every note of a song, it's all a gift.
Absolutely. So two things come into mind when you ask the question, and the first one is probably prayer, and it's something that's stuck with me like my whole entire life. From when I was in, you know, youth group and when I was serving on staff.
One of the main things that struck me as soon as I met you as my children's youth pastor was just your love of everybody and inclusiveness, and the fact that it didn't matter where anybody was, you were just going to meet them right there and accept everybody for who they were. And I feel like that permeated through the youth department, the whole youth. They felt that and they lived that out from the example that they saw. And so as a parent, that was the first thing I noticed. As a staff, we all needed to be intentional about forming relationships with each child and allowing them to form relationships with other adults so that there wasn't just one person responsible for all the teenagers, that they know they had a whole network of adults and other youth to go to. And serving at the food pantry was amazing. I saw such growth in all the youth, and my children especially. If you ask them what impacted them big in that program, that was one of the big things that they mentioned. It really helped grow them in their faith and their ability to talk to other people about their faith. It was just really neat to see.
We did a lot of personality trait finders or strength finders or like a DISC profile to understand each other. We had a staff retreat where we got to go and bond outside of ministry. We talked ministry and we planned, but we got to bond with each other on a leadership level. And what was nice about that is that the pastor who oversaw the ministry and the youth volunteers, you took care of us. You shepherded us. You made sure our needs were met. It wasn't.
The first principle is that that I make sure that my spiritual needs are met. I'm rooted in Christ and solid in my faith, so that when I'm coming to youth group, that I'm there to give and not to receive, because it's not about me.
Yeah, one of the main principles that I remember is the atmosphere of grace. Said that every week, that we're cultivating an atmosphere of grace, so there's no shame in, you know, making mistakes, and that's always allowed, and there's always going to be grace for that.
The principle that comes to mind to me is cultivating life, and that really in cultivating life in the sense of, yeah, everybody has that image of God, so you value everybody. Everybody has value that we need to see the image of God in everybody and really show that love to them.
Number one commandment is to love the Lord our God, and then, you know, additionally to love others. And I value the way that John valued other people. And it was on a level where he would, you mattered to him and you knew that. And
you said kind of a vision of youth ministry and what you wanted to accomplish with the students and really pour into their lives, and you set that vision up to always have the backbone and the solid scripture that we're teaching, but then also the ability just to be unique and do things a little bit the way I'd want to do them on Sunday mornings. That was really fun for me, and I think the students really enjoyed that each week as well.
I mean, people probably talked about atmosphere of grace.
And that was the first time I'd served on a youth staff, and I just loved it. It was, I learned so much and grew so much, and it was wonderful.